Let's begin with the geometric series. So in this lecture, we're going to discuss about geometric series in detail. We're going to look at the one of the property in order to differentiate amongst geometric series. So we're going to associate a new property in order to look at whether the geometric series is a convergent series or it's a divergent series or it's an oscillating series. And let's begin with the content of the geometric series.
Geometric series. So it is defined as 1 plus x plus x square up to so on and up to infinite. So if it x is a common issue in geometric series. So if x is between minus 1 and 1, that is, it is mod of absolute value of x should be less than 1. When absolute value of x should be less than 1 and x raised to the power n approaches to 0 as n approaches to infinite. So 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube up to so on up to n terms. As we all know, it is equal to 1 into 1 minus common ratio, that is x raised to the power n upon 1 minus n. So if n approaches infinite, this x raised to the power n will approach to 0. So it will become as 1 upon 1 minus x, and x raised to the power n is approaches to 0. So it will cancel out. So we will left with 1 upon 1 minus x, which is a constant. So in the if the absolute value of x is less than 1, so we get our given sequence is convergent. So thus, the given geometric series is also convergent. And also, let's see if x is greater than or equals to 1. Now, we have case 1, when x is equals to 1, then we will get 1 plus up to n term should be equals to n, because there is no common difference between any terms. So as n approaches to infinite, so Sn will become infinite, so Sn diverges to infinite. When case in the second case, when x is greater than 1, as xn approaches to infinite, as n approaches to infinite, Sn equals to 1 plus x square up to nth term will be given us by 1 into x raised to the power n minus 1 upon x minus 1 as the formula of sum of the series of geometric series. So limit as n approaches to infinite, so we will get Sn equals to infinite, because xn approaches to infinite, so numerator will becomes infinite, and the given sequence diverges to infinite. So the given series also diverges to infinite, as the sequence Sn is diverges to infinite. So the given series should also diverges to infinite. So let's discuss in the third case where it's oscillatingly finitely. So if x equals to minus 1, so let's say if x is equals to minus 1, then we have one time we multiply with minus 1, then it will be only just its sign change in the second term, and again the we will multiply a second time, we will get again positive term, and that's alternative things we will do up to nth term, which either gives us 1 or 0 according to as n is odd or even. So it will give us 1 or 0 according n is odd. The sequence is oscillate finitely. So the given series is oscillate finitely. So in the oscillate infinitely, if x is less than 1, so these are the conditions which helps us to determine for the value of x. This is the property of our geometric series. So if x is less than minus 1, we have minus x is greater than 1 using the inequalities. Let r equals to minus r. If now we have r is greater than 1, as rn approaches to infinite, as n approaches to infinite. So here we are. So if minus x is r, minus x we have given r, and x is the common ratio. So here we put, instead of x, we will put minus r. We will get that it is equal to 1 minus r raised to power n upon 1 plus r, or 1 plus r raised to power n, because there is also minus 1 whole raised to power n included. So it depends on, again, n is even or odd, we will get respectively. If it is even, we will get 1 minus r raised to power n upon 1 plus r, because minus 1 in the bracket will get neglected, will get shut out. So, and in the second way, in the, if it is odd, if it is, it must be considered, and minus in the outside and the inside will gives us 1 plus r raised to power n upon 1 plus r. So that's how we will get our answer. 1 minus infinite means we will get minus infinite or plus infinite. So it indicates that our given sequence oscillates infinitely. So hence it implies that the given series also oscillates infinitely. Now let's solve some examples and whether C was the value of X and determine it is convergence or divergent or oscillates finitely or infinitely. It is a geometric series with common ratio R. So here R is minus 3 by 4, which means it is, its absolute value should be less than 1. So it's obvious that the given series is convergent. Now let's look at the second one. 2 plus 3 plus 9 by 2 plus 27 by 4. So here we have R should be equal to 3 by 2, which is greater than 1, so which indicates that the given series is divergent. So here we have minus 1 as x equals to minus 1, r equals to minus 1, common ratio. So it implies that a given series is oscillating finitely. Let's look at the last one. Last example, 1 minus minus 5 by 2. So here we have r should be equal to minus 5 by 2, so which is minus less than minus 1. So the given series is oscillate infinitely. So that's about today's lecture. I hope you enjoy my lecture and learn a few things related to sequence and series and the topic name as geometric series in detail.
I hope you enjoy my content, and please don't forget to like, subscribe to my channel. Till then, keep learning and keep exploring, and as always, feel free to email me at dsvfx6789@gmail.com.